Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your favorite introvert here, and today we're going to be talking about exponential curves, or Expo, as it relates to the Mavic Pro and the Mavic Pro's performance. We'll also be covering sensitivity and gain as it relates to the Mavic, so let's get into it.
We'll start off with Expo. Expo, or exponential curves, change the response curve from a straight line to an S-curve, or flatter in the middle, less sensitive, and steeper at the extremes. This means you get more precise control in the range around neutral, where most flying takes place, while still retaining full throw when needed. Expo is mainly an end-user or pilot-preferred setting. Most use Expo to make the sticks less sensitive at center. This allows for finger twitch or handshake to have less of an effect on your flying than it would if the control inputs were directly related to the aircraft's output. What other uses does this have? For sports mode, where the yaw settings are, in my opinion, way jacked up, it allows you to dumb down the movements to a more manageable setting. Stick sensitivity increases or decreases the RC control stick's sensitivity curve in all directions. The throttle stick can be set to how much power is delivered as you move the stick forwards too. It helps the Mavic Pro fly less aggressively or more aggressively as you become smooth and calm on the RC sticks. Sensitivity should be left alone if you are a novice pilot, and then played with more as you learn and progress as a pilot. Braking reduces the amount of time it takes the Mavic to stop once the stick inputs are released. This setting can save you from a nasty crash if you're flying up to an obstacle at a brisk pace and needing the bird to stop suddenly and not continue a slow drifting halt. If you increase brakes to, let's say, 130%, the bird will stop a lot more aggressively if you let go of the stick. If you reduce the brakes to 70%, the bird will brake a lot less. It will be a smoother option, but also it will go a lot further till it stops.
So, what is stick sensitivity in layman's terms? Basically, stick sensitivity is how fast the Mavic enters a maneuver or enters a control once you put it into the control sticks. So if you want the Mavic to respond in a fast rate, you're gonna bump up the sensitivity from 50, 100 to 250%, depending on how fast you want the Mavic to be controlled. And that's for all the control surfaces all around the Mavic. If you want the Mavic as a whole to respond at a faster rate, you bump up the sensitivity, meaning you take it up to maximum is 250%. And if you want the Mavic to respond at a slower rate, you will bump it down or reduce it, and the minimum is 50%. So that is, in a sense, what the stick sensitivity is for the Mavic. Let's talk about gain. The best way I can describe gain is going back to the collective pitch helicopter days and the Futaba GY401 gyro. Side note, does anybody know the 401 and the 9257? A good combination right there. Actually, it's the default combination they used to sell. So Futaba GY401 is a tail stabilizer the gyro, and basically what it did is it felt the movement of the tail as it oscillated or as it moved left to right, and the gain is the sensitivity to the movements. So if the sensitivity was too high, you would start to see the tail kind of twitch in a way that the 401 or the tail gyros was trying to counteract itself. So too much, you would get a jittery tail. And too little, you would have a smooth swaying motion of the tail. And locked in, obviously, the tail's input would only move when you told it to through the rudder channel. So that is the best way that I can describe gain, as in it's the sensitivity of movement that the Mavic is going through, and this movement is placed by outside forces like the wind and Mother Nature. So honestly, I don't know why this setting is even in the Mavic Pro. I wouldn't touch it. I would just leave it as it is. The Mavic is more than capable in its default setting for gain, so there's honestly no reason for that to be messed with. All right, I hope you found this video helpful of the DJI Mavic Pro, the Expo sensitivity, gain, braking, all of the goods explained. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Give me a thumbs up if you liked it, and subscribe for more content. We'll see you next video.